people to know that black fungus is not a new COVID-induced infection. It has been there in hospital setting for years, but it has been extremely rare. In last 10 years, in the whole country, handful of cases have been reported. Suddenly, there are thousands of cases have been being reported all over the country. The root cause here is contaminated oxygen. Medical grade oxygen as compared to industrial oxygen is prepared in a very systematic way. It's compressed, then it is passed through various filters to take out all the bacteria and fungal spores so the patient doesn't get infection. Now it is stored in the cylinder, which is disinfected in a with a very strict protocol, and it is given to the patient in a sterile, clean way. Now, unfortunately, this COVID patient needing very high flow oxygen for a very long time. When you are giving that, the oxygen you could give directly to the patient, it dries up the inner lining of the lungs, then the patient cannot pop out the secretions. So for that, you have to pass through a humidifier where water is kept. And this humidifier, as well as the water, has to be sterilized. The water, you have to give sterile water, not tap water. And this water has to be changed very frequently. The humidifier has to be disinfected or sterilized very frequently. If you do not do, then this fungus is going to grow. So all this combination, when given in the presence of an indiscriminate use of steroid, is causing this problem. Now, steroid is helpful in COVID patient only to fight the effect of COVID, not to stop COVID virus. And unfortunately, if you give steroid when the virus is in the early stage of COVID infection, when the virus is multiplying inside the body, it reduces body's immunity and increases the chance of the virus multiplying and causing more severe form. So that's why it is only given after the virus has stopped multiplying inside the body to fight the side effects. It is easily preventable, and one has to also see that nowhere in the world cases have been reported like the way it is in India. So if the COVID is causing or steroid is causing patients are diabetic, all over the world patients are also diabetic, they are getting steroid, they are also immunocompromised, cancer patients also getting COVID. So, if symptoms are concerned, usually the patients after recovering from COVID goes from the hospital. So, after a few days to week or 3 weeks, the patient starts getting symptoms. Symptoms depend on where this fungus is growing. Most probably it is growing in the paranasal nose and inside the nose and paranasal sinuses on the eyes. That happens, the patient will have swelling of the face, usually one side, pain, fever. And if it is very severe form, headache, if it is very severe form, you can get a discoloration of the nose as well as inside the palate. If that affects the brain, you can get headache, you can get disorientation, then coma. If that affects the lungs, again a recurrence of symptoms, because this symptoms of the black fungus as well as COVID almost similar symptoms. And usually they are fever, cough, breathlessness, chest pain, water collection in the lungs. If the first patient has recovered and again this is happening, more likely it is not COVID, it is more likely black fungus. And if diagnosed by an ENT specialist, they can check out and see if there is a growth, as well as one can do MRI, which is very easy to diagnose.